So Pete, what kind of design principles or design thinking goes into the product of Optimizely?
Sure. So two things come to mind that I think have served us well from the beginning. When we started Optimizely, to see our competitors' products, you had to go through a multi-step sales cycle, which was really frustrating. And so we had no name, we had no reputation, we had no salespeople either. And so we built our product in such a way that anybody could go to optimizely.com and enter their website and immediately get the feeling for what it was like to use our product. And I like to think of that as putting our product where our mouth is, you know? Yeah. And that forced us to design something that was easy enough to use that anybody could get it, because the product was the salesperson initially. Yeah. And the second one I think that really, really served us well was this idea of enabling the novice but empowering the expert. And that comes through when you look at our product. We've built a visual editor. So whether you're looking at a website or a mobile application, you can use your mouse, you can drag things around, you can change text, you can do a lot of simple things without having to understand code at all. But we're engineers, and we were never really all that trustful of WYSIWYG editors like that. You don't typically use Microsoft Word for that reason. And so to satisfy our own itch there, we also made it possible for anybody to go under the hood and see exactly the code that we were generating as a result of all this visual stuff. And that made it possible for a marketer to go in and use it, but also their web developer to go in and see exactly what was going on. We found that that's one of our most consistently used features, to our surprise.